How to mark up an organization using Schema App. Let's go to the structured data editor to get started. The first thing you're going to need to figure out is what type of organization or business are you trying to mark up. There's a couple ways you can do this. First of all, you can go under organization and scroll through the tree to try to find, let's say, a local business that you're looking for, or you can use the search feature. So in this case, we're going to do a restaurant. So we'll go ahead and click on restaurant. Once that's highlighted, you can go ahead and click on the create button to start creating the markup. Schema App's going to ask you to name. This is a name that will appear in the data items list, so it's something that you should recognize. So we're going to call it the name of the restaurant. The URI is the unique identifier that helps us identify what page you're trying to do automatic deployment with. Usually, it's the web page that you're optimizing. So in this case, we'll go ahead and take the home page since that's what we're going to go ahead and optimize today. Click on OK. Now Schema App is going to pull in all the relevant schema.org properties for when you optimize a restaurant. What we're going to do is make sure that we fill out the required and recommended fields. In order to start adding the address, click on the plus sign and then type in the address. Now, often what I have to do is cut and paste that over. If you're not sure what something means, cover over the question mark and see what the definition is in schema.org. This is saying the locality, for example, Mountain View, which is the city. So we'll go ahead and type in Pleasanton. And that's in California. Not sure what the postal code is, so let's go back to our website and pull that off here. And the country is USA. For the logo, it's looking for a URL. If you go ahead and pull off your website, sometimes you can copy the link address directly off the site and just paste it directly here into Schema App. Oh, that one's not so good. So let's see if there's an image. Oh, looks like it's just a link. If you find that the link isn't on the website, you can also go into your media folder, for example, in WordPress, and pull the link of the image from there. Next, we're going to fill out the recommended properties. The first thing is called a contact point. This is how you get in contact with the organization. You'll need to create a new contact point by creating a new data item. Then you're going to name it just like we did when we started this. So in this case, it's going to be reservations. And if there's a page that describes just reservations, you're going to want to put that link in here. If you don't have a page that describes that phone number specifically, you can just leave it the default URL. Now that that's created, we're going to finish filling out the recommended properties and then go back and add some details to that contact point. The same as is going to be Wikipedia links or social media links. So in this case, we do have a couple of social media links, so we can go ahead and add those in there. If you have multiple, you can just use the plus sign to add additional social media or instances and fields to add that social media links in there. To delete them, you just click on the X. The URL is usually the same as the URI, and this is the URL for the page that you're marking up. Under basic properties, we also encourage you to include a description as well as any additional images. Below, under restaurant properties, are a ton of other additional properties that you can add to describe your restaurant. None of these are required for the Google features, but we recommend that you do fill them out in order to better articulate to Google exactly what you're doing and what you're serving. So for example, in the area served, if you're a services company and you're looking to provide service, let's say to a couple different cities in your region, you could go ahead and define them here. Again, you could create an instance, a data item, if they're not already in here. So for example, if you serve Mountain View, you would enter that in. Under the identifier for these cities, we recommend you use the Wikipedia entries. This is a kind of well-known and trusted source for Google to be able to define things. So for example, we're going to use the Wikipedia definition for Mountain View and enter that in as our identifier. Below the type, you're going to have to pick what is it that I'm describing. So you can see it can be an administrator, a geo shape, or a place. In this case, it's a city. So we're going to go ahead and type in city and select city and click OK. If you want to add additional areas that you serve, you could go ahead and use the plus signs to add those in there. You can see there's other piece of things like such as currencies accepted, employees, different events. Again, these are all the properties defined in schema.org that you can use. You can read through them and identify which ones you think are valid for the type of organization or company that you are trying to optimize. So let's go ahead and click save. Now here it's saying, oh, you haven't defined contact point appropriately. And we know that because we just created it. And so now what we're going to do is click on contact point and we're going to click on edit. These instances are actually like connecting the information. So it's saying this is a business and in order to get hold of the business for reservations, this is how you get in touch with them. So again, we're going to call this reservations and it's looking for a phone number. So let's go ahead to our page and grab the phone number. All right, here it is right here. And we'll paste that in. And it is looking for a country code. So we'll put it in the one there and take out the brackets. Again, it's looking for an area served. So we'll type in Mountain View. One of the things with using Schema App is once you create an instance or a date item, you can reuse it across the application. So we're going to do English as the language. And contact point option. So let's look to see what that means. An option available on this contact point, toll-free number or support for hearing impaired. So that doesn't really apply, so I'll go ahead and leave that. And then if you want to further describe this contact point, which is talking about how you contact the restaurant for reservations, you can go ahead and add that additional information. But the required properties are really key here because it's a phone number associated to it. You'll notice under contact point properties, there's also an email. So we do have an email address for this restaurant. So let's go ahead and add that in there. And then we'll go ahead and click on save changes. It is saying, hey, you didn't put in the recommended contact option. I know that because this one's not toll free. Schema App now lists out all that contact point information and tells me that it's coming in from the main data item, which is Sabio on Main. And so now Sabio on Main is done. Now, if I'm using the automatic deployment with WordPress or Google Tag Manager, I'm done. I don't have to do anything else. When that page loads, it'll go ahead and query Schema App to see if there's markup for that page and load that. However, if you do want to cut and paste the code, you can go ahead and click on Actions and click on Get Schema JSON LD and cut and paste this into your page. So that's how you go ahead and optimize an organization with an example of a restaurant.